Hey everyone, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. Real quick update just from me here today, Nick, talking about Cadence Design Systems, investor awareness of Cadence and its larger peer Synopsys have been on the rise, especially in the last year, as it has become increasingly clear the electronic design automation or EDA industry has become absolutely foundational to this AI-powered bull market. The company reported Q1 2024 earnings yesterday, and it looks like media outlets have flooded Google search with headlines stating that Cadence's Q1 earnings were good, but guidance a bit on the light side for the second quarter. Yes, that's true, but this was always to be expected. To keep our NBA playoffs analogies running, Cadence is a second-half team. Slower in the first half of the year, busier in the second. That was always the guidance that they had provided for this year. So let's break the game down for you. Before we go into the first quarter financial highlights, we need to talk about a big acquisition. If you use our semiconductor industry flow to follow this market, you know that EDA and IP portfolios from Cadence, as well as its peers, Synopsys and Siemens EDA, formerly Mentor Graphics, sit at the top of the industry flow chart. And that software and their various hardware that companies use both to design chips, manufacture chips, and then early on in the software development process, these companies have been making some big moves as there's a convergence taking place between mechanical and electrical systems. Of course, the pending mega merger is Synopsys and Ansys, officially announced early in 2024. We often explain that Cadence tends to take a more bolt-on acquisition approach, favoring its own organic development and making smaller purchases. But the company, perhaps breaking the mold just slightly, in early March, it announced the $1.24 billion acquisition of Beta CAE, which would be paid 60% in cash, 40% in issuance of new stock. Beta CAE software does simulation analysis of mechanical and structural designs, especially used by automakers. So likely a bet here on the continued digitalization of the automotive industry. Let's take a look at what that acquisition is going to do to Cadence's balance sheet. So been a healthy balance sheet for many years. See just over $1 billion in cash and short-term investments on balance as of the end of March, and about $650 million in total debt for a cash and short-term investments net of debt of $362 million. Now, that acquisition is going to be paid for 60% in cash, so about $744 million. Cadence said it'll take out a bit of debt to help pay for that, and we'll use the free cash flow generated to aggressively pay that down in the quarters ahead. So expect the balance sheet to look not quite as pretty as it has the last few years as a result. Okay, let's pivot to the first quarter financial highlights, and specifically about the first half versus second half cadence of growth for the company. We talked a lot last year about the big backlog of verification, emulation, and prototyping hardware that Cadence had in backlog. And they realized a lot of that the first half of 2023, with revenue from hardware systems declining from there. That is continuing in the first quarter of 2024. You can see that here in this line item. We have this chart illustrating that last year in Q1, 32% of sales coming from hardware. That is all the way down to 27% this year. As we often point out, Cadence, as well as Synopsys, not actual software pure plays, but that's not a bad thing. These companies have deep, deep roots in the industry, not just an easy-to-imitate, easy-to-copy software business. A couple of developments taking place that is boosting and strengthening Cadence's foundation to this AI-powered semiconductor industry. The first, they have that AI copilot using large language models, LLMs, Cadence.ai. that a lot of chip designers are using to accelerate their chip to systems design. Many of them using that to automate the placement of different chips on circuit boards. Lots of companies getting lots of big productivity boosts because of these new AI software systems that Cadence is rolling out. They've mentioned Intel, Broadcom, Qualcomm, Juniper Networks, Arm Holdings, all making use of Cadence.ai. But we'll pivot back again to that hardware platform. And they had the big backlog that they were finally able to fill the first half of 2023. And just a week ago, they released the next generation of those computing hardware platforms, the Palladium Z3 for emulation and the Protium X3 for prototyping and simulation, that being more further along in the development process, especially for early stage software development. That Palladium Z3 in particular talked about on the call. You may see some reports pop up in the coming weeks about how even a company like Cadence now getting into the custom chip design market, just like all of the big tech and big cloud providers have been, your Googles, Metas, Microsofts, Amazons, and so forth. Cadence said that this Palladium Z3 uses its own custom chip using Cadence's own IP portfolio. However, as we have been explaining or trying to explain in recent months, the traditional chip industry very much a provider of IP for these custom chips as well. And in fact, Cadence's Palladium platform uses BlueField DPUs and InfiniBand networking from none other than NVIDIA. Cadence CEO Anirudh Devgan explained on the call that this Z3 chip was designed by Cadence using advanced TSMC processes. This is one of the biggest chips that TSMC makes. One rack of these things will have more than 100 of these custom Cadence chips, and then they can connect up to 16 racks together. So if you do that, you have thousands of these racks of chips doing the emulation work. These are all liquid cooled and connected by NVIDIA InfiniBand. This is a multi-rack supercomputer. The long and the short of this here is that as companies like NVIDIA need to design bigger and more powerful and more energy efficient chips for data centers, like the Blackwell that we covered after NVIDIA's GTC event in March, much of that technology goes right back into Cadence to fuel the next generation of chip designs from the likes of NVIDIA. So this virtuous cycle, again, we'll just show you our semiconductor industry flowchart here, showing how Cadence's technology just percolates throughout the entire industry and then recycles back up to the top to fuel more development. So who is the biggest customer for all of these new AI chips and AI software coming out? Well, it looks like at this particular stage of the game, it is the AI developers themselves as they continue to try to push the boundaries of what's possible for AI and make this stuff more useful for all of us out here in maybe not the real world, but mainstream world. Lots of other good stuff going on as well. Again, as we've covered in the past, the X3 system for simulation and prototyping makes liberal use of those FPGAs or field programmable gate arrays from AMD's Xilinx. So lots of new stuff coming out from Cadence to help fuel next gen AI chip design as well as AI systems and software design. So this ultimately helps answer the question as to why the first half of this year revenue and earnings are expected to be on the light side, and then ramping up into the second half of the year. Cadence CFO John Wall said that given the recent launch of those new hardware systems, Cadence expects the shape of hardware revenue in 2024 to weigh more towards the second half as their team works to build inventory of the new systems. The updated outlook does not include the impact of the Beta CAE acquisition, of course. It was also added later on in the call that the acquisition of Rhombus's high bandwidth memory IP will also begin contributing to revenue more meaningfully the second half of this year too. And then Intel Foundry Services, or IFS, also has been steadily ramping up the use of Cadence IP as they gear up for next-gen chip manufacturing. So at the end of the day, what does that mean? Well, last year, Cadence's hardware revenue was about $650 million. It's expected to be $800 million this year. So really solid growth. However, of that $800 million expected, just $250 million will hit the first half of the year, but $550 million in the second half, according to CFO Wall. So Q1, light. Q2 guidance, also light. But that was always the expectation from management. So rather than focusing on that light Q2 guidance, let's focus on the full year outlook, because management actually did raise full year revenue guidance by about $10 million and earnings per share by about a penny. Cadence is doing just fine. We did a mock-up of these slides from the earnings report. Revenue guidance for the full year expected to be up 11 to 13% versus 2023 to about $4.6 billion at the midpoint. GAAP operating profit margin expected to be up as much as 1 percentage point to 32%, and adjusted operating margin also expected to be up as much as 1 percentage point. What does that mean for earnings? On a GAAP basis, earnings per share expected to be up just 6% to 8%. Again, a lot of that due to timing of the hardware, new hardware rollouts, as well as some past acquisitions that Cadence has made. On an adjusted basis, which backs out some of those one-time line items, adjusted earnings per share expected to be up 14% to 16% compared to 2023. So mid-teens percentage earnings growth, a bit of profit margin expansion, all what we expect to see from Cadence over the long term. Cadence's top team still expecting this is the early stages of this AI bull market. So assuming that's true, let's do a quick update on our valuation notes. They're in April 2024. We're assuming a stock price of about $269, market cap of about $71 billion after the stock took about a 5, 6% tumble after hours. Based on the updated GAAP earnings per share and non-GAAP free cash flow reported yesterday, that puts Cadence at about 70 times trailing 12-month earnings, about 59 times free cash flow, still very much a hefty price tag, a hefty premium for this company. After the pullback, what does that mean the market is now expecting for Cadence going forward? Per usual, we'll just give you a reverse discounted cash flow model to see what we think the market is penciling in to get it to a fair value of roughly $269 per share. Running that calculation using GAAP earnings per share of $3.84, that's the trailing 12-month, including the Q1 GAAP earnings per share, $3.84. We think the market is expecting roughly 14% earnings per share growth for the next 5 years, an 8% terminal growth rate thereafter, and we used a discount rate of 10%. That gets us to about $269 as a fair value, the current stock price today. Given that companies like Cadence, as well as Synopsys, their revenue tends to follow the research and development spending of semiconductor businesses, as well as big tech, big cloud providers, and others, that R&D spend tends to be, on average, 8 to 10% per year. You add in the fact that companies like Cadence make the occasional acquisition, some profit margin expansion, and some stock repurchases along the way. But we think a mid-teens percentage earnings growth rate is about right for the 2020s, for roughly over the next 5 years. So we think at this point, yes, the price tag does look quite expensive, but after this healthy little pullback, based on our model, we think Cadence is now fair value. That's why we had told you all back in December and January that after over a year of dollar cost averaging into both Cadence and Synopsys, we were putting those DCAs on hold. Personally, we aren't adding to the position anymore at this point. We like where we're at with Cadence and see some other decent buys in the market after the chip crash on Friday. See our last video about that that we just dropped on Monday. That will do it for today on our update on Cadence Design Systems, an absolutely foundational play on the AI market. on AI development. It could be a big semiconductor business. It could be big tech trying to design their own chips, designing big data centers, developing big AI-powered software services, both for their own internal use and for their customers. It doesn't matter who it is. They have to go through companies like Cadence and Synopsys to get the work done. If you haven't yet, put this company on your list of businesses that you need to analyze and understand for this current market. It's a good one. We will be back later this week. Lots of earnings coming our way. Casey and I will be providing updates as we get to it. So stay tuned. Hit that subscribe button. Also, remember, we do have that Discord channel where we are dropping more research notes as we find them and have ongoing discussion on our portfolio here at Chipstock Investor. That's just $5 a month. Check that out. And if subscriptions aren't your thing, we totally get it. You can find the full list of all of our industry show notes and research in a la carte form over on our Ko-fi page. Thanks everyone for tuning in. Casey and I will see you again later this week.